Why is reality television so popular? Seriously. Case in point, the Kardashians had a 20-year run on reality television. Why do we watch the Kardashians? Keeping up with the Kardashians. I know why we watch them. It makes me feel better about myself. I look at them and go, man, they're the beautiful people. They make more money in a month than I'll ever make in my life. I'm a lot better than them. And that's why you like it too. They have all the fame, all the fortune. They take all the trips, but look how messed up they are. I'm a lot better than them. We have a tendency when we're confronted with the goodness of God to compare and contrast our lives with others, and we can always find someone who is not as good as we are. We have this sin nature. We have this tendency to do our own thing, our own way. It's a choice. Love, and God is a God of love, has a choice, and it is a choice. Love wouldn't be love if we didn't have the choice. Don't you see the brilliance, the genius of how good God is? We have a freedom of choice, and with the freedom of choice, there's gonna be evil. And with this freedom of choice, that's where you have true love. But we're sinners. Have you seen the Cowboys Hard Knocks on HBO? Go ahead and lift your hand. I have. People like shy to lift their hand. Lift your hand, yeah, yeah. Dallas Cowboys. I watched that show. I love behind the scenes like stuff, you know, documentaries. It was 49 minutes and 53 seconds. And I thought as I was watching it and as the credits roll, I thought, you know, if someone edited out all of the F-bombs, 49 minutes would turn into about 14 minutes. Why do people talk that way? Why do you talk that way? Why do I talk this way? No one taught it. I never had cussing lessons. I never had negativity lessons. I never had lessons on, hey, Ed, here's how you compare yourself with others and make sure you find someone who's not as righteous as you. Good, man's good, isn't good enough, but God's good is more than enough.